That is most unfortunate. But it doth not release thee from thy fate.
Can you hear me, sir? Sir, stay with me.
Dragon, heed my call. Your will is mine to command. Curses. This arrival of the true risen is most inopportune. Sovereign of Vermin. The ritual must not be disturbed. Let not the Arisen approach. You can manage that, I trust.
It is of vital import that we have a word with Lord Phaedon. The pretender need not be present.
Well done.
I grant you fire blade. Use it well.
Your efforts are for naught, Arisen. Now, simply watch as this world's hollow and fruitless order is remade by my hand. The ritual is complete. The dragon comes. Behold! The Royce Dragon!
By my power, the dogma of dragons is unmade.
You could ne'er understand, Arisen.
We must all be freed from the vulgar order wherein the dragon's existence determines all.
Arisen, hast thou summoned the resolution to face me? Then answer me this. Why dost thou fight? Is it to reclaim thy flesh, thy stolen heart? Or is it to reclaim thy throne? I offer thee a choice. Grant unto me this life in my claws, and be gone from this place. Or stand and fight. Pitiable Arisen. The time for thou to make thy choice is come. Show me the path thou wouldst walk. Go, and thou shalt live to claim thy coveted throne. Fulfill our charges. I as the dragon, and thou as the Arisen. Climb upon me. We shall depart for our true battlefield.
But
rest not. I will know thine answer through the strength of thy will. Thou shalt cut a swathe through the false benevolence enshrouding this world. Arisen, pitiable soul tossed by the winds of fate. Wilt thou slay me, or be slain? I know not how this story endeth. For the outcome was determined in a time before reckoning. And yet, arisen, born of a hapless fate though it may be, perchance, 'tis thy will, and thine alone, that couldst contest the great will of this world. Thou art too late. The hour is upon us. We must decide a victor, and in so doing, form a link in the chain that bindeth this wheel. Tell me, Arisen, what is thy desire?
Turn back.
Leave now, while you can.
Thank you. uncountable created, only to be snuffed out like candles by the cold breath of oblivion. Eventually, the great will, tired of witnessing this, it sought to overturn oblivion by granting unto it a will, a duty, an identity. I speak of the dragon. By the great will does the dragon create a cycle, allowing it to forestall the end of this world time and time again. Yes, there is. This world has been safeguarded by the dragon. You yourself were chosen to form a part of this cycle. The Arisen is selected by the Great Will to play the role of the dragon's counterpart. That is how this world is meant. The dragon serves to continue the cycle, and the Arisen exists to fulfill. This is the true meaning of the Dragon's Law. Once, everyone in this world had a role to play. For a well-crafted tale has no excess. There must be a reason for each character's inclusion. Yet, this means that should even one of these characters stray from their assigned role, the tale entire will unravel. And if it does, their world will end. The Pawns are no exception. Born of the nothingness of oblivion, they were granted the role of aiding in the perpetuation of the cycle. Yet, left of the dragon, that role has been unwritten. Only nothingness selects them now. And there is surely no fate to offer to them than to be possessed by the hollowness of oblivion, only to become one with oblivion itself.
Arisen, I am no longer a mere vessel. Your great will has imbued me with a lesser will of my own. Will is power. 'Tis the means to shape the world as one desires. Master!
Oblivion fades. This tale's end has been unwritten. My heart, it